All right. So just ran into this interview of Super Falcons head coach Randy Waldrum. So he was a guest on the podcast connected to Pittsburgh University. As you may or may not know, that is where the coach is also a coach at. And he was basically speaking about the Super Falcons build up to the Women's World Cup, or lack of a build up for the Women's World Cup. And he didn't hold back any punches in this interview. Definitely came out swinging when it comes to the NFF and the situation he's in with them. I'm going to put the link in the description. Hopefully, if it's not there, please remind me. It's a 31-minute long video, or sorry, audio interview, whatever you want to call it. Definitely a good listen if you want to check that out. Now, when it comes to the interview itself, I felt like it was some stuff that the coach just wanted to get off his chest. I feel like it's a real serious situation if the coach is coming out doing an interview like this. Yes, he does interviews speaking about the national team, but he has never gotten into details like this one right here. He's definitely not holding too much back. He's talking about the team not having enough time to prepare. He's talking about them not having enough time in camp. He said that the reason why he just sent out the 23-woman list was basically because there's no time to bring more players in camp. He also confirmed the story about the team not training for a couple of days during the women's AFCON. And this is basically a story that was going around during the time. A lot of reporters were talking about this. And it's basically that the team had not been given their bonuses. And you're talking about all the way back to qualification, they were not paid their bonuses. So the team refused to train. He said it was a couple of days. Then he said some officials from the NFF flew in to talk to the players, and they had a sit down with the players where they told the players, okay, you can air out your grievances. Then one of the players, Tochukwu Oloihi, the goalkeeper, the second choice goalkeeper of the team, she basically stood up and was like, look, this is not right, this and that. And all of a sudden, after she said what she had to say, the federation felt like she had to be suspended. And that's really crazy right there. You say people should speak their mind, but when they do, you suspend them and stuff like that. This is not the first time with the federation, so you're not really going to be trying to deny it for them, because this is something that we've heard before. But the story didn't stop there. The coach said he kept on campaigning for Tochukwu to return to the team. And finally, the NFF was like, she can make a return if she writes a letter apologizing, da da da, all that stuff. And also, he has to take a certain player, a goalkeeper, to the World Cup. And that's part of the plan. Either he takes the goalkeeper to the World Cup, or he drops his assistant coach. And I'm trying to wonder how the assistant coach got in the situation. Your problem was with Tochukwu Oloihi. Now you're saying that he has to take another goalkeeper or drop his coach. Now it must be said that before the coach was brought into the picture, when the question was just, could you take this goalkeeper to the World Cup? It seemed like the coach was going to go with that situation, but he said he just never got to watch the player or invite the player, something like that. So he basically said he decided to not take the goalkeeper that he doesn't know. And as of right now, that particular assistant coach is no longer with the team. Now, speaking of assistant coaches, the coach did have some kind of slick comments about the Nigerian assistant coaches that he has. But I've heard a couple of rumors about problems in the house with him and the Nigerian assistants. But right here, you see it. He was basically saying they were not good enough. And he was basically saying, he said it twice. First, they're not good enough to replace his assistant. Then they're not good enough to replace him if he doesn't go to the World Cup. And I'm like, why do you have to say that? So there got to be a problem. Those rumors had to have some kind of truth to them. Because you heard about the issues with him and an assistant coach because of player selection right in the AFCON. And you hear this comment now. So you kind of feel like when there's smoke, there's fire. So let me know what you guys think about this situation. Head coach of the Super Falcons, Randy Waldrum, basically aired out all his grievances right before the Women's World Cup. Let me know your thoughts. Do you feel it's a good idea, him coming out saying how he felt? Or do you feel like you should have kind of kept it professional, keep it to yourself? Because when Ngozi Okobi came out talking about how she felt the coach didn't treat her rightly, everybody says she should have kept that to herself. So I'm wondering if the same energy is going to be kept in this situation. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank y'all for watching. Peace.